What's up, YouTube? What's going on? CORYXKENSHIN here, and welcome back to Life is Strange! Finally, the second episode is out. What do we wait for, like a month? It felt like freaking 5 months. So finally, the second episode is out of time. The first episode was amazing. So let's jump straight into this. And back to our amazing music.
In the previous episode of Life is Strange...
What the f***?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done something wrong?
He's freaking drunk.
Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey!
Oh my...
Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
Where the freak is she at?
Something happened to her.
Wait, is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything.
Yo, this episode better go in, man. Life is Strange is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of all your actions, in-game decisions, something impact the past, present, and future. Choose wisely. I'm sure we will. Snooze. Yeah, skip that. Yo, the music in this game was really good. The time machine.
Something good.
Even though it always gets copyright. My first episode got copyright, so...
Oh, something good.
It sucked.
Oh, something good tonight.
Life is Strange, episode 2. Out of time. Sing it. All right, let's get up. Okay.
No amount of rewind will keep me clean. I still need a shower.
For sure. Oh, we got guitar here. Can we play that? I just love how interactive the environment is in this game. She's playing along with the background. How did she even hear that? Okay. Chloe got a message. So, it is good to have minions. Got a bail, master. Breakfast is a go. You there? Like I said, always for you. No boji, meet me at dinner. Okay, cool.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like, no time has passed.
Yeah, shut that off. Oh, that was not background music. The radio was on. All right, well, let's go take a shower then.
I better not leave without my shower supplies.
Okay.
Uh-oh. I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again.
I don't know what that is. I was trying to get the shower supplies.
Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now.
Hold up. Anything else we can do? All right, let's go.
Gordon, seriously? Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like, now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I'm so on it, consider it done.
The freak are they listening to? Some freaking... Oh, crap.
Yeah, of course. course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and
papers. I don't want to hear that freaking hood rap anymore.
Ow!
Whoa, who the freak? Oh, let's see who threw that.
Ow!
Oh, freaking jerks, man. Time out. Isn't this a girls' dorm?
Vortex Club are such pigs. I'm glad I pissed them off.
I didn't think Kate was
whatever
like
they're
this.
Watching must be hot stuff.
Those bros. Ew.
Let's knock on Taylor's room.
Everybody's
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual.
So I could just not. Oh my gosh, these controls.
Clearly not a morning person.
Hey! Hey, what up, Dana? Dang, she
what's happening, here. Dana? Everything cool between you and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again for releasing me from her captivity. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch, Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
Heck yeah.
Why the f*** not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
Hey.
It does sound like fun. Now I have to go contemplate my party future.
Okay. Well, I think Connor's have to- Uh-oh. Someone's getting pregnant. All right, so I think today was the 8th when I looked at our messages. Yeah, so that party is not going to take place in this game. Because we only have 5 days. Hey, Kate.
Kate is an early bird. She might be up and gone.
Oh, what is this? There you go. Can I go to the bathroom? Oh, there it is. Hey, there's Kate. How's it going?
Oh, hey, Kate. Sorry about yesterday.
Yeah, I'm sorry you didn't do anything to help. But you're just like everybody else here.
It's not true. I wanted to help, but...
Whatever. It's done. By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Well, we have the evidence, man. We have evidence. I still remember I took a picture instead of stepping in because we have evidence of that freaking scumbag being abusive to kids. So, Kate, please don't be mad at me. I'm about to take this young shower, though. Mmm. Turn your eyes, kids. Aren't these kids in, like, high school or something? Uh-oh, something's about to pop off. She's about to throw up.
What's up, Kate?
School. That's it?
That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
What?
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right.
Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good sh**.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
Mmm. She's fake as crap.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil bitch. I love it.
You're an idiot. Why do you... What's up with these girls following... Oh, that's about to get deleted real quick. Now, you know, I thought that me and, can't even remember her freaking name. I thought we were on good terms. Did I just put on the same shirt, though? Let me just delete this.
I better get dressed than go give back. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Yeah. I don't care. This action will have consequences. Alright, can I do anything in here?
Hello? Water?
Sorry. I forgot.
What? Really? Yo, I'll freaking run the water all day, man. No way. Alright, so let's get back. Hey, Brooke.
Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
You look distracted.
You look distracted. Everything cool?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will later.
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Okay. Why would Warren be able to explain it? Is he, like, the freaking meteorologist expert or something? Alright, time to get dressed. Is this my... Okay, I didn't know.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week. And he couldn't even rewind time.
That boy Einstein.
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there.
Where's that freaking...
Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. And then fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems.
Very cool. Very cool. Alright. Can I move that?
Be gone, foul soft drink.
Yo, that is insane.
Aha, sneaky book. You're mine.
Just to have powers like that, like, you know...
Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore.
You know...
I do have all the time in the world now.
You know when you were little and you freaking spilled the red Kool-Aid in the carpet and then your dad freaking tore you up? Oh, that's only me? Yeah, rewinding would be very helpful. Private number. Keep your smart mouth shut about everything or I'm coming... I'm coming for that butt! I know where you sleep. Who is this? It must be,
Oh, now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends.
Nathan.
This has to be from Nathan.
Yep.
But it could be anybody. I better be doubly careful around here, or I could be in serious danger. If I'm not already.
Yeah, you're already in danger. Where is, Kate's room? Hey, Kate!
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Matt.
She is just depressed. She must have got jacked. Let's look around. Look at his music, too.
Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now. Damn, it's the all-American zombie family.
Violin.
Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
Oh, something just popped off with her. She put the cloth. She doesn't even want to look at herself. This is bad, man. This is bad. Just snap this picture. Pri could have just started having a seizure. You know how big their eyeballs are. All right, let's go. Oh, I got a trophy.
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why didn't you do anything when David harassed me yesterday?
She is still on this. I wanted proof.
I wanted proof David was in your face.
I thought he was different. I'm happy to see that somebody cares.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
What about the video?
What about this video? And I swear I haven't watched it.
I can't even watch it, Max.
Should I watch it?
Should I watch it? Just for posterity?
Are you kidding? You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
She got slipped some freaking roofies, doesn't sound like you.
It doesn't sound like you. I can't see you partying with Victoria.
I didn't.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember.
Yes?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Nathan.
Nathan Prescott? Oh,
he was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice. What next?
All I recall is driving for a long time. And I woke up in a room. Oh. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And...
what?
And...
were they harvesting her organs?
And?
That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that?
It's over.
I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
Dang. Yo, why did you even go to a Vortex Club party in the first place? And you remember in the last episode that one guy asked me to go? Oh, I'm never going now.
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party.
She got raped, bro.
Should I go to the police?
Go to the police. Go to the police. The police are good guys most of the time. I don't think that we have enough proof, though. And plus, the police work for the city, and the city are owned by is owned by the Prescotts because like they're the most richest family or whatever. Let's look for more proof. They might be corrupt anyway.
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. so I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Yo, you need to chill. They design her like that, so they make you choose the wrong options. We don't have proof right now, woman. But we will.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Yeah, they're trying to trick me into rewinding and choosing the wrong thing. No, we'll be back. Nathan's gonna answer for what he did. But going to the police right now is not very smart. So let's, Oh, wait. Max, food! Two whales! See you there! Don't hurt your fingers sexting. Yay, breakfast! No emoji. Alright, can we go now? Dude, I thought that this entire time, like, with Kate, that maybe she got pregnant or something, and she didn't want to, but this is so much more sinister. Went to a party, got drugged, and probably raped or sexually abused in some way. This is horrible. But hey, Mr. Creepy Janitor. I mean, he's cool. He's just kind of odd. We have to admit that.
Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max.
See?
I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm.
You a freaking Jedi or something?
And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
Let's talk about that snow yesterday.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
Talking in third person, really?
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
I saw a doe.
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me. Like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
Alright.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
What does that mean? Hey, how's it going, Taylor?
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
Let's not fight, please. Come on.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
City. Let's talk about Victoria then.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
How?
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
Of course. Yeah, let's get some rewind action. Her freaking family isn't paying attention to her, so she has to freaking act a fool in school.
I've heard that your mother was sick. I'm so sorry. What happened to her?
Well, if you do care, my mom had back surgery. Victoria was there for me. Like you are for Kate. I'm not about tearing people down, Max.
I know. That's why I wanted to talk.
I'm glad we did.
Hey, Turnip! Alright, let's that was a pretty productive conversation there. Maybe we can get on the good side of them.
Max, get over here.
Get your freaking black eye self.
Warren, what are you doing here?
Oh, nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
Alright, drop some bars in.
By the way, thank you for stepping in. You were pretty Warren. I owe you.
Oh, yes you do. I got knocked on my by that I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
Just a pirate? What the freak does that mean?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star.
Right.
Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
Don't get involved.
He's dangerous. I don't want you to get involved. You got me there, but lay low. Nathan Prescott is going to get his karma soon.
Weird f***ing week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon.
Oh my gosh.
Let's go ape!
Sure.
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
I mean, you did freaking take a black eye for me. Which, actually, now that I think about it, maybe I shouldn't be with a guy that just gets headbutted and smacked in his face. Let's do it. Let's do this. I don't know where we're going. Are we going to school? What the freak is going on over there? Oh, that's Nathan?
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
Wait, why wouldn't Nathan talking to him be bad? Because shoot, those are my two enemies. If those two fighting each other, that's good. Dang, gas price is 407? Goodness! Dude, there is a huge plot at the end of this tunnel, man. Something very, very bad. Wait, what did he just drop me off at?
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same.
Wait, let's talk to this old guy.
No time for chit-chat. I'm a millionaire. Yep. Got my lottery ticket right here. Waiting for the bus so I can cash it in.
Oh, yeah, huh? Good luck with that.
Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got off
the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief. I can't be late for this job interview. I can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
Are things that bad here?
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I sure need it.
Why don't you freaking move then? What is this guy talking about?
Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
You did good.
You did pretty good to have lasted this long.
Oh, the fish used to jump onto my boat until the Prescotts and their finance fiends snapped up harbor rights.
What?
The Prescotts have a lot of power.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay, if that tells you much.
Wow.
Do you know them?
Do good for my working kind. I know them through their bad deeds. Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there.
He's a nice guy.
Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them.
Dang. Man. Hey, man.
Excuse me, sir?
Can you believe this town? The world is on fire, and our big headline is snow. I can hardly wait for next week's big story. Clouds!
One of those skeptics. How long have you lived here?
How long have you lived here?
Long enough to know that Arcadia Bay will be a ghost town in a few years.
I keep reading how Arcadia Bay is booming.
The paper can only talk about that or about missing girls.
Rachel Amber?
You mean Rachel Amber?
I guess. I bet she ran away because she was bored. Who wouldn't be here?
Nah, I don't think she ran away. The hobo? Homeless woman?
Hello.
Aw, look at you. A fine example of youth. I bet you're a senior student.
Yes, I go to Blackwell Academy.
I could tell you're a wise young woman. I know all about Blackwell and this town.
Hmm. She got the insight, like the homeless people in Oblivion. All right, well, give me some info on the Prescott.
I bet you have dirt on the Prescott family.
That whole family is dirty. They once done good things for Arcadia Bay. Those days are dead, like anything in their way.
I know somebody who's being threatened by a Prescott.
Then you be their guardian angel, because nothing gets in the way of that family, especially not the law. Hell, they own your school, Blackwell, almost.
Especially not the law. See, it was good that we didn't go to the police.
You must know Joyce Price from the Two Whales Diner.
She's fed me more than my own family. How's a daughter your age who's always in trouble?
What happened?
Married to a real prick.
David.
His name is David Madsen.
He told me to get a job once, asshole. Not sure what Joyce sees in him, but he better treat her right.
I have to go now. Goodbye.
Aw, man, I want to talk more.
Come talk to me any old time you want, young lady.
Can we give her a dollar or something? Alright. It's finally getting inside the diner, I guess. Uh-oh. Something's on fire. Fire! How far can we go?
I don't want to go that way.
Yes, you do. Rachel Amber posters everywhere.
Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again.
Hey, Joyce. She'd probably be like, oh my gosh, if it isn't Max. Hey, Mr. Cop.
Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Why do they always say that? I'm not freaking lost, man. No, I'm just hungry.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now that is a real problem at the Two Whales. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese.
Let's talk about David.
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
His reputation.
He kinda has a reputation at Blackwell.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
Okay.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard that Chloe even had a pot dealer in her room.
No big thing. No, that's not good.
That's not good. Anyway, that bacon sure smells good.
Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
She can be.
She can be, but she can also be a good friend who shows up when you need her.
Sounds like you're a good friend. I wish she would be a great daughter and not cause Joyce so much stress.
Let's talk about
Joyce.
How
well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
Okay. So first thing we do is go outside to the RV. Hey, Mr. Sketchy Frank RV man. How's it going?
Stop that. Stop. No barking.
There was something creepy about that guy and his dog.
Like what?
There's that dirty RV from the other day.
Can I go around? Oh, I need to bring some food for the dog. That's what I need to do. I'm gonna get some food for the dog. Banjo. Oh yeah. Right, are you gonna see me now?
And there she is, a lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart.
Mm.
But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot.
Mm.
I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man, no matter what Chloe says.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. It was very stupid. I'm sorry.
It surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands? She's changed.
Chloe must have changed a lot during that time.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair.
My gosh.
Now she's gotta rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Do you? He's not as much of a as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
I did.
I did. And I am sorry. I don't want Chloe in any more trouble. Or me.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I admire that you took the heat for Chloe. Like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
That's why you smacked her in the face. He cares about Kate, huh?
He cares about Kate Marsh?
David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
Yesterday, I took a picture of him fighting with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty.
Mm.
What do you want to eat?
See, she's in denial. Go ahead and give me that waffle, but anyway.
The last good Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
Dude, there's no way. There's no way she's defending him. He hits her or something. Because
one Belgian waffle for the hungry girl, pronto.
One Belgian waffle at 12 o'clock high.
I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
Hmm.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner, not a bar.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty. Stick with the bacon.
What the heck? Yeah, if she cares so much about him, then she should probably want to hear some of the stuff that I had to say about him.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment.
I just have to sit here and wait.
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
Dang, she hooked that up in like
I'm
30 seconds.
Like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh God, Mom, please do not give Max any for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl, a woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this on the jukebox?
Uh-oh, that guy is about to get mad at the other booth.
Now that that's out of the way.
You freaking animal.
Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Keys.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
How about razor bullet?
A bullet. Just like your necklace.
That was so wrong, Max. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets.
Aw, I was wrong. Dang it.
That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
Okay. Cigarettes. Some change. And hold on, how many cents is this? 75, 80, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 86 cents. And a warning ticket for parking out of parking bay. So let's rewind this.
So this is me telling.
Okay, Max.
Parking ticket?
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
Really? Are you kidding me? 10:34.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time. Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
Okay, you got some money?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as f***. How much do I have?
Glad we counted. 86 cents.
86 cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
Okay, keys.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
There's a bear. Panda.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Really? Cigarettes?
I'm pretty sure you
How many cigarettes are in there?
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
We didn't freaking count them, okay? But there was a lot, probably like seven.
Seven cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool.
Yeah.
Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck.
I bet you did, you scum.
You have powers.
I know.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
Okay, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
I want some freaking waffles
Man,
right
I'm
now.
I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
am freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way!
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Alright, she waved. Get some cups.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a... Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside. What the freak?
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Okay, so quite the sequence of events. Still trying to take mental notes.
That's the best song I've heard.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
Davy Jones.
So what are you waiting for?
Now I should rewind and tell Chloe everything that just happened.
All right. Hey.
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
So first thing, Trevor drops his glass. Yeah.
The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So what happens next?
Then it's alert on the cop's radio and he answers.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio and he answers it.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
And Justin and Trevor fight and Joyce stops them.
Justin and Trevor are fighting and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
And finally, jukebox goes crazy. The cockroach crawls on it. The fly lands on it. A butterfly lands on it. I didn't see what landed on it. Let's say fly landed on it.
The jukebox goes crazy as a fly lands on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
All right, let's see. Here we go.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
not, slap Max. Me, take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
Wait, so, oh, he ignored the call? Oh, a cockroach crawled on it. Tucker drops his
mug. The trucker dropped.
And then, Lert and his partner leaves.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just...
Joyce stops him.
This is getting...
As a cockroach.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, man.
This should be it, finally. Oh, this is a different point of view.
Did you break another cup?
Oh,
really?
Go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a...
Slap me, take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever.
She is horrible.
You can make anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened.
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, girl wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave.
Why'd they just, like, blow off her nose bleeding? Like, a freak? I'm like,
Chloe finally believed it. And I wonder what kind of crazy she has in mind now.
Frame rate drop? Let's go.
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and people to do. Come on, before people mom starts some more, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out.
Can you hold on for like 60 seconds? Are you kidding me? Are you freaking serious right now? Over, like, can I be like, yo, let me just say, like, I'm out with my girl. And then she calling her B word? No, Chloe. I mean, like, yeah, it's been 5 years or whatever, you know what I'm saying? But come on, this is important. There's like an investigation going on with Kate. Like, I don't, let's just answer him.
Hey, Kate, what's up?
Please don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay?
Shut up.
I promise, Kate, I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Nah, damage.
Thanks, Max.
Relationship points with her.
If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now, let's rock.
That didn't seem like it was too harmful, but watch, answering that phone call has just changed everything.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument. I could rewind and not answer Kate. It's not like I won't see her in class later.
Let's go. We answered the phone. I don't care anymore. This freaking guy. The guy in the RV. What's his freaking stake in all this? It's horrible. You know what? He probably abducted Rachel Amber. The girl with two first names.
Is this a race?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
Yo, this is my power. Chloe, her personality is a
Are
little
you kidding?
Too...
After yesterday, I'm kind of over guns, Chloe. Freaks me out that you have one.
Don't you trust me?
Yes, but not that gun.
You have more power than an army. Don't be scared of my little toy. Besides, we need it for the test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles. Pretty please.
Okay. No need to get all in my face. What do bottles look like? That's a can. Let's look around then. Hey, that's one bottle.
Hello, bottle number one. 4 more to go. This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here.
Well, that's bottle number two.
Boom, only 3 bottles left. I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this?
Freaking emotional.
So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared. Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel.
Warren. What do you want? We'll have to get supplies for the drive-in. Maybe we can have dinner fast or whatever. Anyway, go wait. Too late. I don't care. Leave me alone, Warren. I have things to do.
It kind of hurts. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. I can't see Chloe playing with me.
Hey, number three.
Three down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack.
There we are, number four.
One more bottle to go.
And I have a feeling it'll be in her hand.
I have to find dirty bottles while you chill? Not fair.
I have to prep the range, crybaby. And I've been tripping hard about where you got this rewind power.
From God or the gods? So, bow.
We can make the world bow. Are you ready for that?
No way.
No way. I still don't even know how my power works, or for how long.
Dude, you f*** up, you rewind, you fix it. Drop the mic, boom.
Spin, rinse, and repeat. I'm just altering time and space. Oh yeah, and history. No biggie.
You already altered history by saving my life. Let's see what else you can do.
What's going on, Kate? Okay. So, Max, sorry to have bothered you by asking for your advice. I guess shouldn't do anything but let people enjoy my video all over the world. Okay, that's still not what I meant. I just want you to be careful. Too late, I guess, but thank you for answering my call this morning. I really needed a friend and you delivered. Yes! I'm on your side. Love. Talk to you later, baby.
I prepare the shooting range while you look for some bottles.
Hey, bottle number five.
Voila. Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
What? Really? Why did that even happen? Hey.
Thanks, Max.
Finally got all the bottles.
Wait, one more for the road.
You're serious about this.
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max,
can I shoot?
You have to help me aim.
Yeah. First person shooter.
Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Okay.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir.
She is like drunk, man.
Duh.
That was so cool. Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
I gotta watch her miss every single time. Oh my gosh, it's gonna take forever. Up.
Aim slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, okay. Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here.
That's why I just spent 45 minutes getting the bottles. There you go.
Give me something to shoot, Max.
Yourself?
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
They could have ricocheted and killed us both.
Like, never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Let's hit
How about aiming for the left
thing.
Tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death.
Whoa. Whoa!
Uber cool.
And we got the bottles.
I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero. Now it's your
Not
turn to
really.
Bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose.
I don't feel so super.
Max!
my gosh. Of course. She freaking used too much of her power. Never should have came here with her.
You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. But I feel a woman again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
You see what just happened to me?
Max is afraid. I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a show, don't you, Chloe?
Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
No, you better.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the f*** are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Get the freak out of Dodge then. What, they want me to shoot him? Oh, we're got to shoot him just so we can see what it looks like.
That is hilarious. Oh, man. I'll remember you, kid. I'll remember you almost shot me. And you'll wish I had no memory because I never forget.
Rest in peace.
You have until Friday to pay me. Don't ever pull crap like this again. It'll be the last time you do. Try bullets next time, brainiacs.
Dang, dude. She literally pulled the trigger, too.
Sorry.
You are awesome. Thanks for standing up for me. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't f*** with us again. He just wants his money.
Yo. You know what?
Jesus, I almost shot this guy. And now he'll be more dangerous to Chloe and me.
Yeah. I'm really not liking Chloe anymore. Because every time we stick up for her, like, we're just getting in more trouble. She's like that friend that, like, drags you down. You know? She's on our own path to destruction. Well, of course we're not gonna shoot him.
Come on, girlie. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
Oh, man. That did not go good.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step should have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today.
I don't know how to feel about that.
Frank took Chloe's gun because of me.
Nah, I'm just gonna keep it that way. This is really getting interesting. I don't know.
Wowzer. Why did Frank have Rachel's bracelet? We need to talk about this later, but I better follow Chloe now.
Well, where the freak did she go? I don't know. Shooting at him? That's like way out of character. That would probably like cause some freaking trouble later. But at the same time, I like that what this game does is like, yeah, you can rewind time and change your choice, but it's like, still in the grand scheme of things, you won't know what happens. Very, very interesting.
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me, especially for stupid
mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
Nah. I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around?
I just gotta say something. I'm sorry. I know that him taking that gun was a huge mistake. I'm calling it right now. I'm calling it. Chloe is going to be in a situation where she needs that gun and she's not going to have it. We just messed up the whole game. I'm calling it right here, right now.
Scary losers like Frank. It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
I'm freaked out.
I'm still freaked out about what happened. That was awful, Chloe.
I'm sorry. But Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit's the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank.
Why do you owe him money?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember?
Wow.
Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out?
Hung out? You don't mean you...
Ah, no, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
Be careful.
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smart like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect.
Chloe.
Oh, and she's having problems with her powers. She probably won't be able to rewind if something happened.
What's that noise? The train. Oh, sh.
Take your freaking boot off, you bum.
I don't want to die here. Get me out of here, Max.
What can we do? Oh my gosh, can I look for a stick to pry her out or something? Just runs home.
I can't budge it at all.
Come on. We gotta break it with a brick. Come on, why are they making this part so complicated?
Please, get me out of here!
I don't know.
Damn, something is blocking the drum.
Really?
Max!
I'm coming. Let me just get something on from over here. Oh,
the
gosh.
Coming. Max,
I'm coming! I just gotta take care of a few things.
Max, get me out of here!
Get the wedge!
This wedge locks the drum in place.
Please.
Oh, gosh!
Please.
Let me just rewind that for a little bit. Okay, let me see that.
Please. I can't even move it an inch.
Oh my goodness! Okay, let me just rewind a lot. Cause this is rough. What's this?
I can definitely use this bad boy.
Oh yeah. So I'm gonna bust a window, right? That's what I need to do. Come on.
Score.
Oh yes. I'm coming. Just hold on. Give me the next.
Okay, what can I slice with this?
Is Chloe about to die right now? I think Chloe's about to die right! Dang.
I missed something. I better rewind.
Man, they should show it. All right. Well, that just takes like all of the thrill out of it. Okay, got the axe. Now what? There you go.
Now I can finally move the drum.
Okay.
Get me out of here, Max!
Okay. On my way.
I have to help lift Chloe up.
Get me out of here!
Okay. Now I got an axe. What do I need the fire axe for?
That was close. You saved me again. Crazy. We were totally vulnerable. You okay?
I got splinters in my leg, so I wish there was a less violent way for you to save me. And now the trains can't get to the lumber mill. Oops. Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
No. It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Says you. You're gonna freaking get busted up acting this way. She needs a life goal, a life plan, you know. Not being so destructive and such a miscreant.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
What do you know?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like you said, Professor Price. A superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a week, and yet one of the best of my life.
Because we're back in action again.
Gets in a car accident. Let me stop. I really have some strongly mixed feelings about Chloe. Like, this feel like she's, I don't know. She needs a epiphany. See where she's going. At the same time, you know, she's like an OG friend, so it's like, you can't just bail.
I have a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
Look at this freaking scum. What do you want?
Sir?
Hello, Max. Would you like to tell me what you wouldn't yesterday?
Fire alarm.
There was just a lot going on, with the fire alarm and everything.
Yes, but you were distracted by something else.
I can't focus when I'm scared.
Please don't say that. There's nothing to be scared of at Blackwell Academy. Our head of security is overseeing a new era of campus safety.
Hassle Kate?
I saw Mr. Madsen hassle Kate Marsh yesterday.
Wait. Do you see a pattern here, Max?
Probably not the same one you see.
You won't tell me the truth about yesterday, but you want to tell me the truth about Mr. Madsen. That sounds more like sour grapes. Excuse me now.
I don't even know what that means, cue ball. Sup? Freaking.
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
No.
No, it belonged to a friend of mine. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you, but it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
Is this guy really a bad guy after all? What about Kate?
What about Kate?
I shouldn't have said anything. You know about that video going around.
Is that why you hassled Kate yesterday? I took a photo of that moment for surveillance sake.
Soldier, you don't have the facts. You think I'm a hypocrite because I want cameras around here for the safety of the students?
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
Yo, I'm actually about to change my mind about this guy, but like, at the same time, why does he need a camera in Chloe's closet? I don't think, well, that's like breaching freaking privacy. Hey girl, I'm in the sci-fi lab now. I'm no something kitty. See you soon.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab.
Hey!
Luke is always using the phone as a shield to avoid people.
Yo, Luke? Yeah. I'm making his video. And I like some Oreos. Life is Strange Part 2. We going in here, boo-hoo. Yeah.
All
right, let's go.
Victoria and her friends shopping
for Juliet, what's going on, you guys?
Juliet is laying the smackdown on Zachary.
Yeah, looks like the smackdown, all right. Looks like she's about to give him something, if you know what I mean. Who is this? Is this my family? I guess she made no comment about that.
Yo, Maxwell Smart. Talk later, cool?
What you freaking doing in there?
Yo, Maxwell Smart.
You want some drugs?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
What?
Kate!
You don't understand mine. Nobody does. Nobody.
Kate, Kate,
please,
talk to me.
Leave me alone.
No, we're gonna talk about this, Kate. We're gonna talk about this, Kate.
Stop! Don't come near me.
Nope, we're gonna talk about this. We're talking about this.
What do you want from me?
We're talking. We're talking about this. Kate!
Just leave me
Kate!
Alone!
Well, let's talk to Courtney.
Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care.
I do.
I'm not anti-soiree. You seem anti-fashion, though.
Ooh,
a
shots.
Vortex Club party has a strict dress code. Do you even have a dress? Sorry, but nice try.
Okay, let's redo that.
Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Max.
Really?
Oh.
Dress code?
I'm sure the Vortex Club has a dress code. As you can see, I would need your advice on what to wear. Thanks, Max. I didn't think you noticed high fashion. Tell you what, I'll put you down on the guest list, and before the party, I can give you some tips.
Cool.
Thanks, Courtney. I'll send you the party info later. Back to the list.
All right. So that could be important later. Maybe we can run some espionage, get into the party, and see what really goes on. What's going on, Zach?
Hello, Zach.
Sup, Max? It's weird to not see you without your camera.
I'm always taking pictures with my eyes.
I bet. As long as you don't talk to everybody about all that with the sext in Victoria.
It's over.
It's over. Just another Blackwell mini drama.
You mean stupid. Man, I just don't get Victoria. What does she want?
Probably for all of us to talk about her. Like now.
Then let's not. You're pretty smart, Max. See you at the game Friday.
Oh, Zachary, is he the good guy that Victoria was trying to jack up? Jam up? Alright, let's go. Samuel, what'd he do, shouty? Oh, he's just doing his work. Guys, just chilling.
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me? I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
You're not the only one. Do you have something you want to tell me?
I saw David and Kate.
I saw David Madsen harassing Kate yesterday. He was scaring her.
Mr. Madsen confuses fear with security. I'm sorry. Kate had to be a target of his paranoia. If you had proof, I could talk to Principal Wells.
Oh yes, I have an actual photograph for once.
Let me see that photo after class. You're already thinking like a real Max? I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out.
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes.
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
Rachel was nothing like Kate. And Principal Wells said you had something on your mind you wouldn't tell him. You care to share?
Rachel was nothing like Kate? Why did he freaking sound like that? I don't trust nobody in this game. Not now.
Not right now. I'll tell you everything as soon as I figure it out.
I'd like to believe that, Max. It just seems like there's a lot of drama around you this week.
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Freaking Resident Evil sound foot effects. Mm-hmm. Who are you talking to?
Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go.
Oh, this guy.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll do that.
This guy helped out.
I know. That makes sense.
He just doesn't see me eavesdropping in front of him. Okay, he could just be talking to a pregnant wife or something,
sure.
But...
okay.
No, I don't trust anybody in this game.
Make me beautiful.
I guess I'm out of time to turn in a photo for the contest. Irony. Stella is smart to stay out of all the drama.
Then right. Show me the look.
What's going on, dude?
How do I look, Taylor?
What's up, Daniel?
You look like ass.
Waiting to drop Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on.
Hayden. That's that guy that invited me yesterday, right? Yeah, this guy. I don't trust this guy either.
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
Well, y'all want me in a... Hey, that... Alright, y'all want me in a picture or no?
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal. Like I give a flying f***.
Or she'll run to Mr. Jefferson, like he gives a...
Like anybody does. Max is such a little...
Shh, I think she can hear us.
Get the freak out of my chair.
Here comes the mysterious Max, disguised as a pixie hipster.
Like all the other precious twee artists here.
You really nailed me.
Meow! Bring out the claws. I love seeing chicks fight.
Right. Can I sit at my table now?
Max thought we were going to be buds. Ha ha.
How that scratch on your face feel, Nathan? Freaking Kate. Who's following her?
Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What? What is he doing? Alright, that just further solidifies my previous statement. There's no one that can be trusted. Not even Warren.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit down. We have a lot to cover today and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves.
This teacher dropping knowledge. Hold on, we gotta get back in this conversation. Who texted me? Max, wish you had popped a cap. Okay. No, Chloe, I do not wish that. Neither do you. Is it too late to rewind? Yo. Go on with that, man. You didn't messed up your own life.
We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest.
Oh,
like
don't
Max
look at
Caulfield,
me.
For example.
Gosh.
Who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark.
The I shadow guess Kate will miss class now. Such visual power. I'm worried about
it's
her.
It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contract.
It's cool that Mr. Jefferson
just like me
his
too.
Own little book of photo tips.
Like, I'll like be like all in class for the first like 30 seconds and then as soon as it gets contextual, I'm like, nah, I'm good.
Of their contrasts. Although we don't technically see in my...
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated.
Wow. Nice
dismissed.
Classroom power. It's about to go down. It is about to go down. something about Kate.
Is this for real?
Flipped out.
I didn't think she was that messed up.
What did Kate do? Oh my gosh, what is happening?
Kate!
Oh my gosh!
Oh God. I have to do something to help her.
Oh my gosh!
She can't.
She really did it! She really did it!
Not oh no! Again. Not now. I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
Well, they didn't even give me any time that time. Wasted on my freaking powers with Chloe. I do not like Chloe. Wasted all of my time. Oh gosh, it won't let me. I just stopped time. Move forward.
Keep going, Max. You can do it.
Come on. Please. My gosh. Let's let her land on me or something. We need something. Wasted all my freaking powers with Chloe. I am so mad. Okay, what can we... Oh, look, he was trying to do something. What was he gonna do? Where am I going? Am I gonna get all the way up there? Oh, wow. This girl, Kate, didn't care anymore.
Yes.
Hurry up. Freaking snatch her butt off that. Say something!
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself.
Oh!
I have to get another Pulitzer shot like
oh.
That.
This is it, you guys. No more power. Alright. At least we don't have a time limit. I want to prove. She's not even listening to that. I had no idea. I've been bullied too.
I've been bullied too, Kate. And even when I got picked on, I stood up for myself.
I know you only stand up for yourself. That's why you let David get in my face. Like everybody here.
Oh,
that's
gosh.
Not true. People want to help you.
Yes. They want to help kill me. And they can get their wish.
Kate, your life is still yours. And we can get through this together. Let me help. Like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
You're my friend.
Of course I worry. You're my friend, Kate.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone.
Mm-hmm. Don't answer
the phone.
I always
feel like you really listen.
Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I
please.
Know I can. This morning I erased the web link to the video.
Mm-hmm.
It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Too dangerous. I'm gathering proof. I wasn't sure. I needed more time. I'm gathering proof.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. So you have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon. Then straight to the police. Think of it like we're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Mm-hmm.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So, I want you to come with me now. Please. You don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body.
No.
Horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
There are billions of videos. Be strong. Everybody will forget.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Forever. Can we hug on it?
No. Nobody cares about me.
What?
Nobody.
What the freak did she just said? She was... Mother, your father, your brothers, your sisters? I don't think we have this information. All we saw was a picture of Kate. Oh my gosh. Your sisters.
You told me about your sisters. Especially the youngest one. What's her name?
That's Lynn. She's only 10. She does have the best smile ever. I would hate to see her sad.
Then make Lynn happy and step towards me. If she was here, you would know what to do. This isn't the end, Kate. There's no way God doesn't have big plans for you here.
Nice try, Max. But God put me on this roof.
Ooh! I cannot remember. Those two verses were in her... Oh. Well, suicide is a sin, but... She's definitely... She doesn't care about that right now. One of the quotes, one of the scriptures that she had, Proverbs or Matthew. Matthew.
Come to me, all of you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest.
Matthew 11:28.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe you quoted one of my favorite passages.
Like I said, I care about you. I know this passage means a lot to you.
No!
I'm sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
Let's go! We had to fight for that one. We had to freaking fight for that one.
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody. But I'm so proud of the way Blackwell pulled together to save a young girl's life.
Y'all ain't do nothing!
Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah. Real hero.
As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
Nathan dosed her? Nah. We have no proof yet. We're not ready to make that statement. Jefferson made her cry. David bullied her. Oh, we got to pin this on somebody in the room? I mean, like, the go-to option would be X. I mean, like, we can't do anything with Nathan yet. Jefferson, he hasn't given us anything. We got proof that David bullied her, so, I mean...
Mr. Madsen was bullying Kate.
Oh, grow up.
Excuse me, I was there. I saw you getting in her face.
You have no idea what you saw. Kate Marsh was involved with a bad crowd. I was trying to find out who.
Kate had a double life. I was super shocked when I found out.
No, you were part of the crowd. And like I said, I personally saw David physically harass Kate Marsh.
You lying little...
Shh.
Are you gonna take this junkie's word over your security officer? I know she smokes and deals marijuana.
That has nothing to do with Kate. Here's a photo I took of David and Kate yesterday.
That's not... not proof.
Hold on. This isn't a courtroom. But I feel it would be in the best interest of Blackwell and this situation to put you on temporary leave. We will continue this conversation later. Hopefully with Miss Marsh when she's out of the hospital.
Are you kidding me? This is major. I led troops into battle, and you're letting this punk lead you?
No. I am sorry, David.
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and student just tried to kill herself. They don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now. I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
Yo, I got a feeling that this freaking David guy is like, he's like trying to figure out what's going on. But why was he taking pictures of Kate? Regardless of that fact, we can rewind it. Because I want to see what the freak will happen for all three of these things. And we got our powers back, so we can do that. Alright, let's see this Nathan.
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and
playing
the field.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Something happened to her and you know it. How about we talk about you waving a gun in the girl's bathroom?
That's total slander. I could sue you and this school so fast. I already have a personal lawyer.
Wait, Max. You told me that nothing happened yesterday. Are you just making things up? How can I trust you?
Bad.
You can't. She's smoking and selling dope, not saving lives.
No, I'm not. And that has nothing to do with Kate Marsh.
I'll have to investigate to see if this accusation is true. Therefore, Max, I'm obliged to contact your parents and suspend you for a few days.
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need...
Okay, so clearly, bad option. Please. I mean, I already knew that was a bad option, so that was just for posterity. Let's see what happens if we do the teacher, which is the most random one.
I saw Mr. Jefferson talking to Kate right before our class. Then she ran off crying.
Mark, I do know that Miss Marsh has assisted you on class events.
Kate, Miss Marsh has been very withdrawn lately. I assume this awful video was the cause. I hated seeing the students laugh at her. She was upset Miss Caulfield didn't return her calls. She felt rejected by the school.
She shouldn't have asked to be on video, macking with some dudes.
She didn't ask for any of this.
No, on the contrary. Max was right to bring this up. Now, I wanted to help, but I guess I was too late.
Well, now this is problematic. The publicity is rising, and perhaps you shouldn't represent Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes contest in San Francisco.
Are you serious?
I am. We don't need any negative press about that event. And we need to involve the Academy in possible disciplinary measures for you.
I understand. There are bigger things at stake than me. The life of a young girl, for one. Maybe you should investigate other staff members. Max told me she knew things about Mr. Madsen.
Oh, come on.
Let Max speak for herself. Everything we talked about here will be looked into. All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here.
All right. So, I was right, man. I was right for that first one. The only sensible one is the teacher. Maybe getting him suspended will allow him to do some undercover detective work. Because those other options weren't cutting it. All right.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
Shut up, you drunk. As soon as we walk out, he's gonna pull out the booze from under his desk. Like I said, no one's to be trusted. However, we just saved Kate's life. Clap that up! Somebody slice that like button. I don't know, man. That part got me so hyped. Gosh.
I couldn't even believe it was happening. It was literally slow motion as I grabbed her hand. And then I could feel her grabbing mine.
Max, that was the greatest thing I've ever seen. Ever! You reached out, she reached out, hugs, tears, applause. Like a superhero.
Not quite. Look at me. I'm a mess.
You're glowing. Seriously, a human halo. I'm pretty sure you earned your wings today.
I'm still worried about Kate. She did try to kill herself. All over a video.
Viral is the right word. Like a disease.
So you watched it?
Just one. And a half times.
Lauren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight up b-head. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this?
Another
the
weather anomaly.
Confirms this weird day.
Eclipse.
I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
I believe you, Warren. I believe anything this week.
Hang up that hat. Like I said, I don't think David is the bad guy here, but who is he? Oh. It's a principal talking about. What is she crying about? All we learned about him is his name is Frank and he sells drugs. Saved your life, Kate. We gotta help her, man. She got drugged and then they posted a video of her. That is... Again with that ending. Tape. I don't know whose house that is. Are we about to find out? What? What? Oh my gosh. Dude, that was insanity. I'm on the verge of crying right now. Dude, good job to us. We saved Kate. I cannot believe that we were able to do that. Like, I always make the wrong choices when I play these games, and the fact that they took away the powers at the end, it just, it gave that extra amount of fear that I was like, I just can't go back and rewind this. And I'm sure there's going to be a bunch of YouTubers that just fluff that part up. But CORYXKENSHIN is not one of them. We saved Kate. But going forward, David lost his job. I don't know what consequences that's going to entail in the next episode. But episode 2, out of time, that was very, 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 very exciting. Hope you guys enjoyed another episode of Life is Strange. I'm out of breath after that, man. Now we just gotta wait another month for episode 3. Yay! But man, they're definitely worth it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode of Life is Strange. If you did, be sure to Samurai slice that like button. Really helps out. Subscribe today to join the Samurai. And until next time, my brothers and sisters.